With the great eclipse just over a month away on April 8th, you may be wondering exactly what'll be going on in the solar system to create such a rare spectacle. So this week, we're going back to school to help you better understand the eclipse, how it works, and what to look out for. Today, to demonstrate what a total eclipse is, how it's different from the partial eclipse our region experienced in August 2017, and to explain some words you'll be hearing closer to April 8th, here's St. Michael's College astrophysicist Elaine Brizard.
The moon will, first of all, cross the plane on which Earth and the sun move, and will get in front of Earth, between Earth and the sun. And when that happens, the moon will cast a shadow on Earth. And the shadow itself is called the zone of totality. When you look at the shadow of the moon on Earth, there are two regions. One is called umbra. That's the zone of totality. And the other one is called penumbra, a much bigger zone where you can see a partial eclipse. In 2017, we were in the penumbra.
This is awesome.
So we could still see the sun.
Oh, I can see it!
Because of the geometry of the sun, the moon, and the earth, the moon never covered the entire surface of the sun. That's much less rare. But a total eclipse, again, you're talking about a dot the size of about 100 miles. Traveling, we will see, traveling at about 2,000 miles per hour. At the same time, the Earth is rotating, the moon is moving, everything is moving, so it occurs very, very fast. Come out and see something that you will not see again in your life.
More from him tomorrow with other great knowledge about the total eclipse.